Sister Brown, to the chair lady of this great service, to the minister, officers, and all Christian friends. It is my task to introduce the mistress of ceremonies for this evening's service. There is a mental process that one goes through when seeking caution for a certain task within the church. For this one task, the committee one is number one, someone who was willing to help us make this a memorable occasion for our dear pastor. And what better person there is that knows about helping than the president of our missionary society? Secondly, we wanted someone who would understand the significance of this service to our pastor and his family. And our MC for this evening is a widow of a minister, the late Reverend S.W. Jones. We also wanted someone that was filled with the Spirit of God. Someone who was a Christian and was going to help us pray and lift up the name of Jesus. A Christian woman and a bold soldier for the Lord. So I present to you our mistress of ceremony for this evening's service, Sister Evelyn Jones.
Program is going to go down on the church that gets here this year. Our program provides a selection of visitors and members and friends, it's just a pleasure to be here this evening. And I don't know anybody any happier at Mercy Seat at this time than Sister Steph. When you really get something good, and you know you got something good, it's something to be happy about. Now, I've been guilty, and some of our friends around here good about canvassing, they've accused us of their work. But I said, if I did canvass, wasn't it worth canvassing for? Yeah. You know, you canvass, but if you have to canvass for something good, you just tell the truth about it. God sends ministers. They're not made by people. The Bible says that God, some are evangelists, and some are preachers and prophets and teachers. But we have one that's kind of all wrapped up in one. We have a preacher, a teacher, an administrator. We just evangelists. Whatever you might say. We had a preacher, been to some churches and heard some preachers who were really dynamic in speaking, but they just didn't make good pastors.
Watch out.
And then I see some real good pastors that just wasn't the best preacher that I've heard. But we thank God that he gave us all of this record in one day. And I'm a mercy to Christ. Seven months ago, you'll see the difference now. The members have something to come back for. They're anxious to come. We never have a Bible class like we have now. And this was started by our pastor. Right. And we just can't keep your fast enough, but Wednesday night, 142 people present. And our goal is 150. And of course, when we get to 150, we're going to work. So we are so happy that the Lord has sent us a leader. Now, I'm one in Mercy who has seen pastors come and pastors go. For all the years I grew up in this church, and then I happened to be at one time the supervisor of our little children. We had our little Easter programs and Christmas programs. Jimmy always played a part in those programs. So we had our little junior choir, our little Bible class. Jimmy Brown was one of our little boys that took part in everything. So we know what we have. We don't have to guess. You know, there are all kinds of people out there wanting to get a church, and they don't want it too far the saving of souls. People are out there for a living and think it's an easy living. There are some people coming out of prison with a hymn book and Bible and sending resumes to people's churches, wanting to be the pastor, and they want it for what's in it. So you have to beware, you know, as you. But we are praying that Reverend Brown will let the God lead him. The Holy Spirit lead him. Not me, you, relatives, or anybody else. Be led by the Spirit of God. And if you let the Spirit of God and God lead you, you can't help but go. We are so grateful of having you, Reverend Brown. I was so disappointed at one time I didn't know what to do. I gave up. I told the Lord, I don't know anybody else. I just give up. Do whatever you want to do, Lord. So I told the Lord, he will hear and answer prayer. And he asked for something. And he knows, he knew that we needed a real good shepherd. We did pretty good on our own, but any church needs that shepherd. And the young man in the back there, and some other, two other ladies, we never gave up after we, after our disappointment. We started working all over again. And we want you preachers and everybody to know, Reverend James Brown didn't pursue us. We pursued him. We worked him to death. But he was being led by the Spirit of God. And when God gave him the answer, then he accepted the call. And we thank God. We are ever grateful to God for sending us such a good leader. And now my prayer is next year this time, we'll be just as happy and just as enthused as we are at this time. You know that. I know our race of people love you today and don't love you tomorrow. You get a little bit of water turning on and on. But I'm praying that next year this time we'll be just as in love with our pastor and just as enthused over our Bible study and the different programs he's bringing to us. Reverend and Mrs. Brown, may God ever bless you. May you live long. Preach an unadulterated gospel.
Thank you. I'd like to also do this while I'm here. who want to express our sincere and heartfelt sympathy for the Henderson family, who at one time was a part of the North Bend family, but because they're over here, we're over there, don't make us don't care for each other. If you don't care for each other, then you're not a Christian. And we want you to know that we are praying for you, that God will touch you. Because everything God does is good. He has never did nothing bad. And we want you to know that if the North End family can be on any service, please let us know. And we will be glad to. And mercy seek, don't make this the last time I'm fighting North Bend. If we can't join in and sing praise God down here, don't look for them.
I'm a mushroom ball.
Pastor Crockett, to our other pastors, associated ministers, to our special honorees this evening, Pastor and Sister Brown, we are representing the New Era Missionary Baptist Church, V. St. Louis, Illinois. We have come to celebrate with you. When you find something good, I thank you all to share it. And I heard somebody say the other day, as they tried to describe the love that Jesus had for his church, and they said about him, what a friend. We're here this evening to say to you, what a friend we have over here with you, Pastor Dr. Brown and Sister Brown. Treat them well. Be good to them. God bless you. We're praying for you. New Era is going to come with an A number. They're on choice.
Thank you.
members of the union meetings on behalf of the mayor, the administration, and the entire city of East St. Louis. Her office could not be here on Sunday as it was scheduled to do so. So we asked, as I was coming tonight, knowing that this is my former pastor, that I would be here, he asked if I would make the presentation. We would like to say to Dr. Brown and Mrs. Brown, and to you that do not know, Dr. Brown has been an asset not only to North End, but the entire city of East St. Louis. We are praying that if he would be just half as much to the city of St. Louis, Missouri, then he would definitely be a high point, for he was more than an asset to East St. Louis. At this time, I would like to read this certificate of merit and present it to Dr. Brown on behalf of the American City of East St. Louis. It says, East St. Louis, Illinois Certificate of Merit. This certifies that Dr. James Brown Sr. has performed meritorious services as minister in the city of East St. Louis, Illinois, and pastor of North End Baptist Church. In recognition of this achievement, this certificate of award in East St. Louis, Illinois, is 15th day of November, 1985, and it is signed by the mayor of East St. Louis, Paul Paulson. Amen.
Thank you.
to just have a few words. I'm listed on the program as pulpitarian, but my space had been used up when I got here. But while my choir is coming forward, I'd like to say that I'm so grateful to be able to be here and to help you to celebrate the wedding of friends of mine. For truly, a pastor, if he's called of God to a church, is married to that church. Amen. We are certainly grateful to see such a beautiful start. Actually, it's really beyond the marriage stage. I believe we are celebrating a honeymoon at this time. And I'm so grateful to see such joy, such love, such happiness, because Reverend James Brown and Mrs. Brown are very true friends of mine, and they are some wonderful people. And certainly you are blessed to have them with you as leaders. You're certainly blessed, and you already feel that you're blessed, for I've heard you say that he is doing great already. And I just encourage you, Mercy Seat, to get behind your pastor, support him, pray for him, and be very cooperative with him. And you haven't seen the height to which you can reach. We'll now be favored by a selection as requested in our letter when we received the invitation from the Greater New Hope Baptist Church. Amen.